are builders. We are crafters. We are fighters. We are Bear Hill Shire.
Jacob Lepine, Sir Aidan McBarrel, the Baron of Bear Hill Shire. I am doing a crude submission for my advancement. What I'm making now is crock pot chicken. I learned this recipe from my dad and I made my own little twist on it. Small twist, not a huge one. So what you're going to want is 4 to 3 pieces of chicken, onion chopped into a quarter, salt, garlic salt, potatoes, carrots, if you really want to put carrots in there. Bouillon cube with water and cream of mushroom and cream of chicken. These are your best friends when making pot roasts. Oh, and also a very nice crock pot, which we'll be cooking today, but we will be saving until tomorrow. Okay, so start off, we're gonna drain the chicken. We gotta wash it, and we gotta cut some of the fat off if there isn't. Do the funky chicken on the floor with the chicken in your hand. Bring them over. Now you're ready to start cutting the fat off. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna do that. Next thing you're gonna do, you're gonna get either a fillet knife or just a regular knife. Since I can't find the regular knife, I'm going to use this, which should work just fine. What you're gonna do is you're gonna cut off all the excess fat. What we're gonna do now, and since these are huge pieces, we can cut them in half. When you're done, stick them in the pot. Same drill with the other one, cut off the excess. Enough. Cut this puppy in half. Get it in there. Step. We're gonna chop up some onions. And first, always important, wash your hands, especially after dealing with raw meat. Also, another important tip is to wash all of your equipment after use. You really don't want to cross-contaminate when it comes to food items. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is you want to chop up some onions. You always want a quarter cup. All you need, this. And unlike my dad, I don't really have a problem chopping onions. Not so bad, once you get used to it. And since I'm out of knives, I'm using this, which I'm not supposed to because it's not a chopping knife, but whatever. Another thing you want to do with this is just mince. That's all you're doing with the onion, just mince it. And basically all you're really doing with a crock pot meal is that you're just throwing all your ingredients together in one big pot and you're letting it cook for a good 3 to 5 hours. Measure out our onion, make sure it is all nice chopped and even in the cup here. That's a quarter cup. Next thing you want to work on is the potatoes. You can just cut them in halves. That works too. First, you want to rinse them off though. Just rinse them off, get them all nice and clean. Rinse off your cutting board quick. One of the things we need to use in this recipe is bouillon cubes. So what we need to do, this is kind of provides the broth of the whole thing. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a bouillon cube The recipe usually calls for two, but I usually cheat the system with a one bullion cube and a ramen noodle packet. It gives it a lot more flavor. Makes it taste quite awesome. So after that, I'm gonna throw said bullion cube into one cup of water. Then we're gonna add the ramen noodle packet last. And we're gonna stick this in there for about 4 to 5 minutes. So 4:30, 4 to 5 minutes. So now we're gonna start cutting up our potatoes. So in half, and we're gonna do this about 5 times. Okay, now that your potatoes are all cut up, you can add soup. Done. Now I'm gonna activate the magical cat device and we'll have cat incoming, and here they go. There's cat one coming in. Cat two is on its way. So now all we do now is just add both soup cans to the dish. So once the can is completely empty, you're gonna fill it with water and then you're gonna stick a little bit more back in. Just so you can get all the extra juicy goodness out. Need in this kind of thing is just one can of water. You do want to rinse out your cans though to keep the mold away. And they also make great grease cups, so you always want to save at least one. Okay, now that our bouillon is done, we add the ramen noodle packet. So you want to give it a good stir, mix all the nice juiciness together. Done, pour it in with the rest of it. Good. Then you want to add some veggies. You can either add celery or carrots or both if you really want to, or you can just go without. We have gone without so many times, it's perfectly normal to do either. Put the carrots in. And once you're all done filling this up, you want to give it a good stir, make sure everything's all mixed around. That way all the spices and stuff aren't sitting in one place. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add the spices. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add garlic salt and salt with a hint of pepper. So 1 teaspoon of garlic salt, 1 teaspoon of kosher salt, and 1 teaspoon of pepper. Make sure this gets all nice and even. We're gonna get a lid on here, mix it all around really good. Make sure all the juices and the sauce and everything in here gets all nice and mixed together. Then we're gonna refrigerate it quick and leave it for the next morning. Or afternoon, or whatever you decide to cook it. 6 hours to go. Takes about 3 to 5 hours, depending on which heat you use. You do it in 3 hours if you cook it on high. You can do 5 hours or 6 hours if you cook it on low. You always want to go with low because that way it gives the veggies and the meat and everything time to, you know, get all the flavor into them, and it breaks apart a lot easier. It's always nice. That plus it gives it a nice tender taste to it. Now that this is all mixed together, all nice and good, I'm gonna put a lid on it. We're gonna refrigerate it.
Good.
Okay. Now, since we've officially made room in the fridge, we're going to stick this in the fridge.
This has been a production of Bear Hill Films.
I like a super size Sprite.
Sir, can you please repeat that? I'm getting a hissing sound.
Now we're walking over to the fridge, sticking the onion back inside the fridge, closing the door, going back over here, taking a drink of Miller. Here's my drink of Miller.
Squirt me, I swear to God, Dad.
Do 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 do.
If you'll excuse me one moment, please, while I go beat the shit out of this motherfucker. Sorry about that. Let's get back to work.
Cooking with distractions.
Cooking with an ass whooping coming up in a few minutes if you don't shut up. Please get the cat out of there.